Well, joining us for this very special interview is Mayank Kumar from UpGrad, the company that's really grown at the pace of more than just a unicorn, and the company has achieved unicorn status just recently. Lots of developments happening at UpGrad, Mayank. A very interesting journey. You know, the last couple of months have been very, very significant, achieving unicorn status, getting that last bit of funding in. What does it mean to you, achieving unicorn status at this point in time, when there are more than 37 or 38 unicorns in India this year already?
I think, Priya, first of all, unicorn is a mythical character. So it's a myth that we are all sort of chasing right now. I think there is definitely a sense of excitement as a founder that you have built something that has reached to a particular level. At the same time, as we get to that stage, I guess the stakes increase. I guess the ability and the responsibility of actually having taken money at a certain value and therefore delivering a return to the set of investors, that expectations increase. But while there's a great sense of pride and excitement in achieving that status, at the same time, there's a fair bit of responsibility that has come along with it to making sure that you are able to deliver A, returns to the shareholders, B, returns to the customers who have actually trusted us in building this out, and C, provide a great place for learners, for our employees to actually build a meaningful career at UpGrad. So I think it comes with its own sense of excitement, with its own sense of responsibilities along with it.
Talking about employees and looking at, you know, adding value to their career goals and path, you already announced a policy on ESOPs where you all have sort of expanded the ESOP school for employees. So tell us a little bit about the thought process behind that.
No, look, I mean, ESOPs is a very integral part of, I mean, any organization's growth at the stage where we are. And look, for employees, they are giving their sweat and blood and time in building something along with us. And as part of the process, if we feel, and as founder group, we genuinely feel that, look, without the support of the employees, and more importantly, support of the families of the employees, I don't think we would have been able to build what we have built so far. So there's a lot of hard work, a lot of belief that the employees have put on building what we are doing at UpGrad. And therefore, it is but natural for them to also enjoy the wealth creation opportunity along with the organization growth. Because at the end of the day, if their skin is in the game, they will go all out to achieving what the organization wants to achieve, because they all see that one common goal of growing the organization. So we believe that each individual who's putting in the hard work, putting in the right amount of dedication, ends up becoming part owners. And once you're an owner, then even before you leave the office and you see a switch light open or a fan switch open, you will switch it off and head out. I think the responsibility comes with the ESOPs coming in. And we are very happy to share that as we sort of go and grow in the entire process.
Right. I also want to talk to you about the core business in terms of what the strategy is, because I believe you all just announced a consolidation of three business units, which is part of your larger strategy. So how does this all fit in and what kind of roadmap are you looking at?
So I think on that, Priya, when we started our journey with working professionals. And now today, as we have expanded, we have now become more an integrated lifelong learning platform. So how, from the age group of 18 till the age group of 50, 60, we want to engage with learners at different age group and help them move up in the career. So whether you want a bachelor's degree, you want to go abroad to study, you want to take up a government job or a private sector job, or you want to sort of study within the campus with a skilling and upskilling program. We want to provide that for the college learners and for working professionals at different stages of their journey, whether you want a master's, diploma, certificate, doctoral degree, or B2B enterprise learning solution. So for us, what we have done over a period of time with the set of acquisition that we have concluded, we have now taken up a pure lifelong learning journey approach. And as part of that is where the consolidation sort of comes in, or rather the merger scheme comes in, because we believe that there are not six, seven, five, six companies who are doing it. There's one single entity UpGrad, that is holding the customer from the age group of 18 till the age group of 50 to 60. And that lifelong learning partner is very important. Look, I mean, both of us, I'm assuming that you use your telecom operator on an ongoing basis. You have a banking partner. You do have an insurance partner. You do have a health insurance partner, but you don't have a career partner or an education partner for yourself. And that's the vision, that's the ambition that we want to achieve as part of this merger. Having said that, to your earlier question, Priya, what's a growth strategy for us? We break it down into two broad buckets, or let's say three broad buckets. The first one is we definitely want to go as deep as we can in the existing space in India. And we want to achieve that either via organic growth that we have established for ourselves, or via inorganic and M&A approaches that we have charted out for ourselves. So we are looking at both organic as well as inorganic growth to go deep in India and be at least 2 to 3 times larger than any next competitor of us in the country. B, our very clear focus is going to establish Upgrad outside India, whether it is looking at developed markets of US, UK, Southeast Asia, and establishing presence there, which we have offices now present in, or looking at emerging markets similar to India, like Africa, and looking at positioning ourselves in these geographies also. So I think both going deep in India and enhancing and establishing a leadership position and establishing presence in geographical expansion in developed market as well as a developing market. And that's what we are sort of currently working towards right now.
Right, when you talk about at the number of courses that people have been doing at Upgrad, do you think there are specific focus areas where you see the future or a large number of people really looking at enrolling in these kind of subjects, if there are top three courses that you feel people are looking at this point?
So right now, it's gone quite diverse, Priya. So I will not talk about specific courses. Let me give you a sense of what are the subject areas or the domains that people are looking at. The number one for us, or the very close first and second, is the data ecosystem. So anything to do with data analytics, AI, machine learning, that's definitely quite a lot in demand. The second one, which we were quite surprised, is this entire online MBAs, global MBAs, management education. For many people, CAT is just a one-day phenomenon, right? I mean, if you do well in that day, you end up taking a business school admission. Otherwise, you are out of the business school rut. And once you start working, you can't take a break and take up anything during working. So the MBA portfolio has become very, very important and much larger in our portfolio. And then we have a very long tail, Priya, of technology courses, full stack development, coding, as well as law, design, supply chain, healthcare management. Those are long tails, but the two largest one I would say would be the management portfolio as well as the data portfolio for us.
Right. A final question before I let you go is on the listing front. We're seeing so many new age internet companies go ahead and list on the stock markets. Any listing dreams for Upgrad anytime soon?
I think there's still time, Priya. I think there's a lot for us to do at this point in time. There's a fair amount of work for us to build the entire lifelong learning platform piece that we spoke about. We believe that IPOing is definitely on the cards. Is it on the cards for us in the next 12 months to 24 months? Perhaps not. Is it on cards for us in the next 30 to 36 months? Yes. I think we need to do a lot of groundwork before we go ahead and look at listing, because look, at the end of the day, listing at a mid-cap level does not make much sense in India. If you're listing it, listed at a certain level that you are among the top 50, top 100 listed companies in the country. And for that, there is work to be done. And that work is what we'll focus on the next 24 to 30 months and then look at listing right after that.
All right. On that note, man, many thanks for joining us today on the Daily Dispatch. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Thanks for your time.